And you know, when this announcement was made and we first were able to break this news yesterday, Ron and I put our brains together and we thought, we need to get someone who has a real basketball IQ, that is a genius, if you will, when it comes to basketball. Well, we called Jeff Portnoy. He was not available.
Right.
So Scott Robb joins us this morning.
Bottom of the barrel. You had to dig deep to find me.
You know what? Scott not only does radio, I don't want to sell him short, he also does the television and covers UH men's basketball. What do you think of the new hire? 33 years old. First off, that made me feel old.
Yes.
But tell me more about Eran Ganot. I want to make sure I get his name right. That's the first thing.
Yeah, it's actually a Jewish name. Mm-hmm. Some people think he's French. He's not French. But, you know, he's 33 years old, spent time here under Riley Wallace and also Bob Nash. At St. Mary's was the associate coach. He's a guy who's up and coming. A lot of folks know him here. And I don't know him that well, but everybody I know that knows him well really likes this hire.
Talk about this program and the state it's in right now, because obviously this season has been sort of shrouded in controversy with the NCAA investigation that's underway. What's he going to have when he gets here as far as players? Because we even saw Isaac Fleming with a sort of cryptic tweet yesterday saying, I enjoyed my time, as in past tense, here in Hawaii.
Well, the rumor was there were two or three guys were going to leave regardless of what happened. That happens now in college basketball. Mm-hmm. Teams lose players all the time. That's a good question. I think a lot of it's going to depend on what happens once the NCAA tells UH what their punishment is. I think a number of guys have no options. They have to stay here, which is good. They have a good core nucleus of guys. The question is recruiting. It's kind of late. Who's going to be able to find, who's going to be able to bring into the program for next season?
He was at St. Mary's for the past few years, and that's a really successful basketball program. So, I mean, he has a knowledge, and he's been around winning program. That's got to be a good thing.
Oh, absolutely, and I'm sure he has recruiting ties. I'm sure he already has. He had contingency plans in terms of if he got a head coaching job, who would be his assistants and things like that. He's a very well-organized, bright young man, so I wouldn't be concerned about that.
We'll find out 9 o'clock this morning. Obviously, Scott and a lot of the others are interested to see exactly what they do. And I guess this is sort of the first hire for David Matlin. So his regime is underway, right?
Yeah, I mean, he's officially not even the AD, and he's already hired a new basketball coach. What a way to start.
All right. We'll, of course, be streaming it online at K212.com. Let's head back into our Wake Up Today studio now with Ron and Diane.